Here we're going to have a look at creating a particle system. So first we want to do is have a look at where the particle systems are. We're in the geometry part of the panel, and then click on this drop down and here you'll see particle systems. Now particle systems allow you to emit all types of different objects or particles. So we'll go straight into one of these here and we're going to have a look at the super spray. So click on this, just like all other objects, you just click and drag in one of the viewports. I shall do this in the perspective viewport. You can drag, and you can see this is now facing straight up. If you look at the icon, remember you can rotate the viewport by holding down the Alt key and the middle mouse button. So you rotate and you can see the arrow is pointing straight up. Let's maximise this viewport. We can have a look at playing the particle system quickly. So if we click on play animation, you can see some particles are coming out. Now it's a quick short burst of 30 frames and we're going to have a look at modifying that quickly. So back to frame zero. In the modifier panel, we're going to come right down to load safe presets. So we expand this part of the panel and we'll have a look at some of the presets. So that's what I think we'll have a look at bubbles. So I'm going to load that preset and I'll zoom out slightly and we can just scrub along the time here and you can see that we have some of the effects already applied. And we can render this quickly. Click on the quick render button, you can see that we have some bubbles. Have another quick look at one of the others. Look at hose. Load this one. You can see the effects changed. Load speed, the distribution, the amount of particles all depend on certain parameters. And these presets already have these set. So render that one and have another look. You might just be able to make that, if I zoom in slightly, you might just be able to see some of the particles in this view. Anyway, in your own view, you'll be able to see this. Now let's have a look at creating our own particle effect. So I'm going to load the default settings and scroll right back to the top. So at the moment our particles are only coming out between starting at frame 0 up to frame 30 and then they stop being generated. So if I just go to frame 30 and we can have a look at some of the parameters. So the first one is the off-axis and this, as you can see, points the direction of the particles. I'm going to leave this at zero and same for the plane. If we change this, you can see it rotates around the actual off axis there. Again, leave this at zero. I'm interested in using the spread and you can see here along the off axis you can see that we're spreading the particles out quite wide, and for the plane we can spread them out again so that we have sort of more of a 3D sort of particle emitter. So you can see we've now spread these particles out. So let's have a look at some of the other options that we have. We'll go to particle generation, and the first thing we see in particle generation is two options, use rate and use total. Use rate, that'd be 10 particles emitted each frame. At the moment we can't see all of them. If I just come back up, you can see percentage of particles is showing 10% of the particles. If I put that all the way up to 100, that is the actual number of particles that we're going to see. So if we render that, although we can't actually see them because they're very small, if I zoom right in, you might just be able to make them out. Let's zoom out again. The shortcut for zoom there is Control Alt and Z, which zooms right out onto the 100% for the whole particles to be shown. I'm going to reduce the particles down, back down to 10%. It's useful because it allows you to just have percentage of the particles so it doesn't slow down your viewport too much. Now, the speed of the particles is how far they are dispersed from the emitter. So if we slow the speed down, you can see they're not travelling quite as fast. Increase the speed, they move a lot faster. I'm going to leave this at 10. The variation. You'll see this coming up a few times, such as down here in the particle timing section. That's a percentage of whatever value you have here. So if we want the particles to vary, then we would have 50%, and we could have 50% plus or minus of this number 10 here. I'm just going to leave that as it is. Now, first thing I want to change the particle timing is I want it to actually start emitting before frame zero, so that the particles are already in action. So I'm going to actually go reducing time. I'm just going to go to minus 50, and I'm going to go up to 150. Although our animation is only from frame 0 to 100, it just means that the particles are definitely going to be emitting throughout the whole animation. Obviously, display until frame 100, we're going to finish at 100, so we can leave that. The life is how long the particle is actually going to live for. When it reaches 30 frames, it will stop and a new particle will be emitted in its place down the bottom. So, if I was to reduce this, you can see in the viewports our particles aren't living as long, so the effect is much shorter. And again, you can do it up higher and it will last longer, and the variation, same as the variation for the speed, it will be very percentage wise on the life. Now, the size of the particles for these ones, which are quite small, if I increase them, let's put type 10 in and render this, you can see the particles a bit clearer now. If I put 50, quite clearly you can see the triangle shapes. Again, variation, same thing. You'll have different sizes. Now, the grow is how many frames the actual particle will get bigger for, and then the fade is how many frames it will shrink over. So as the particle leaves the emitter, it will get bigger and bigger and bigger, reach its maximum size, and then for the next 10 frames right at the end, it will fade. Uniqueness, you can make particles different based on that, so that's a pseudo-random number. Next one that we're going to have a look at is the standard particles. Metaparticles and instance geometry. Instance geometry is quite useful because you might, instead of wanting dots and triangles, you might want to emit something completely different that you've modelled. And I'm going to just emit a teapot from our particle system. So if I click back on the super spray, and you can see here I've done instance geometry, scrolling down, I can pick our teapot. And now the emitter will actually emit teapots. In the viewport display, if I click on mesh, you can see that we now have a lot of teapots. The effect there is due to the fact that I've increased the size, and I can make them much smaller and zoom in. And if I play the animation, you can see the teapots being emitted from the particle system. Rotation and collision, making the objects spin. If you don't want them to spin, set that to zero, or you might want them to spin. Now, one thing that I want to do is I want to change the speed so they're not moving quite so quickly. So that they're just hovering around the particle system, or spread them right out, and we can render this, and you can see all of the teapots, and you can see here the effect I was talking about, where they grow for 10 frames, reach their maximum size, and then shrink again. Again, you can use any objects, I'm just using teapots for speed. Let's see if there's any other options that we can have a play with. I think what I'll do is I'll let you have a little look at these ones in your own time. You can just have a play and see how these work out. But as a quick introduction into particles, have a play, try some of the other particle systems that are available, and don't forget to look in the help file.